Tata siyaphuma ngoku semasete.
Siyaphuma ho semax man.
Yebo.
Yebo tata.
Eh,
semax.
Yebo. Fanga phambili man. Chrome. Hey, Chrome yabizwa. Yeah, mndakwethu.
Hayi Max, emotional ngoku ngidawu.
Yeah, mndakwethu.
Yeah, this very emotional.
Very emotional.
We are leaving behind people that we care about.
Kunjalo tata.
And this area has contributed. Has played a contribution to who we are today. So siyaphuma ngoku. We are not sure of when we are going to come back. So that's why we are very emotional about it.
Mm.
It's really nerve-wracking and emotional draining. But the game makes either way. We have to be strong.
Yeah.
There are two choices in life where you have to decide whether you want to sit back and nurse pain or you want to pick up your pieces and carry on. Yeah, so we chose to just pick ourselves up and just carry on. Yeah, there are three things Max in life that you must do. One of them is always say please and thank you. The second one is that you should always trust and have faith in God, no matter how the situation seems like. The third one is never trust your eyes, because your eyes will always draw a situation. What you see, but your faith will always overlook what you see. We have lived in this place for more than 8 years now, and this, we are making a grand exit. It's the first time that we see rain. August figure, it's the first time that it rain again. You know, so I think it's a blessing in disguise.
It's a blessing in disguise.
We are living. Fellow friends, family, and compatriots behind. But we believe next week was Obuya and to bring development in this area.
Mm.
So, everybody that may be watching this thing, never ever give up in life. I equate pain a permanent. Every pain is temporary. No matter how painful it is, it's always temporary. You will never find a permanent pain. Everything. It's always temporary, and we'll talk from experience. Many people know our pain, but we never chose to sit back and nurse that pain, because we understand that when you nurse pain, it keeps on coming and coming and coming, and it actually arm. So to everybody that supported us, Policy Lab, and everybody that kept on praying and not sleeping, we are human, we made our own mistakes. Took a portion of our own mistakes, made them, moved on from them. And everybody that prayed for us, and everybody that supported what we did, may God richly bless you. Bless your families, your children, your sisters, your brothers, your parents, your grandparents, your aunts, your uncles. I pray that God will fulfill your needs and God will provide for you. I pray that God will bless you, and I pray that God will guide you and protect you and your family and generation. And I pray that everything that you want in life, I speak fulfillment, I speak prosperity, I speak rejuvenation, I speak regeneration of the soul, the body, the spirit, and the mind. And knowing that in everything, give thanks unto the Lord. You know, and I came across a text once, reading my Bible, and and Paul was saying to some brethren, he said, I therefore urge you, brethren, that you continue with the race that you have been granted faithfully, administrating God's view in his various ways. And you must never cease and be weary when you do good, knowing that your struggle and dedication does not go unnoticed, the Lord. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Because Max.
Yeah,
man. Ngoku mntanam, singene Kraydog. Xa siyibiza sithi kaladog.
Kaladog.
Kwalapha kusawutshintsha uthetha sawuwela. Yeah. It's soon.
Finally reached the crate of work, Dagamax.
Yeah.
Sukasuma said it's a bit cold here.
Yeah.
Some gabonet out of Gabanaka cool with that. I managed to drive. How many minutes was it?
I think 40 minutes.
I think 40 minutes from Somerset East to here to Kraydok. So, since I'm coming and destination here to Pretoria, and hope for the best. Yeah, it's sad to leave this place, Somerset East included, because it's only fair to say that a part of us lies there. So it's quite an emotional experience when we go. It's a very long time, but it's all for the best. You know, we are working towards success and we are striving towards excellence. So these are some of the decisions that one needs to take. Max Magasia and Masinga and Apple, so that we can just refresh a bit.
Yeah,
yes. Oh, it is go lights. Abanda banga.
Nom Fontaine, Celtic. Punya Celestine.
Ah! Oh, the town of Punya Celestine.
Yeah, the town of Punya Celestine. Yeah.
Fully profited, whatever.
Yeah.
Very big. Very big.
Oh, that's very big.
Oh, Sir Max.
Oh.
Yeah, I guess young can go up in doors.
From
funding.
Yeah.
We sound to you born.
Yeah.
Scapa Lamadot.
Scapa one at that.
Yeah.
Yeah, on this journey.
Yeah.
Eh.
Sabella.
Cabella.
Costa.
Chichin Papa.
Pacific, a buy a brass. We are Colonia, that is Sulis Swane, Spedi, because without Chetis Corsa, as a go from the Goya,
as a
go,
oh, Manga Womb.
Yeah, this is Manga Womb. Costa,
good. I seem for a terrible thing.
Hey, hello, Bloemfontein.
Hey, guys.
Majesty, disco lights.
It's us.
We are here
in Bloemfontein. We are continuing with this journey. The twins are going to China on Sunday.
Yeah.
So I will be seeing them off on Sunday at the overcame international airport. It's been a struggle for the past 5 years. These guys have wanted this thing to happen and it has been a struggle for them, but finally Super Mario.
Finally,
Super Mario.
Yeah, it has been something that has been on and off, Max.
Yeah.
Yeah, all the time.
Yeah. You
know, getting opportunities and having those opportunities taken.
That happens well.
It's like music. You can see it was at the corner in the July. I cannot know it at this point in time.
Yeah.
We are just traveling, Jay.
Yeah,
brothers and so on. I'm going to be team.
Yeah, I'm going to be
Many corner, brothers, everybody, they're taking it on that. And stuff. And people saying a lot of negative things. Some pretended that they wanted us to succeed. But you know, I've learned something, Max, that you know, there are limits that people set for you in life.
Boundaries.
Boundaries, because they've never reached certain points in life. So they only, you know, people would clap for you and applaud you when you do good, but will have a problem when you do better than them. So many people would encourage you and clap hands for you when you haven't reached the limit that they've set for you. But immediately you start breaking boundaries that they know that it was difficult for them to break in their lifetime. Then it starts to be a problem, and boundaries that their children failed to break, you know. And we need to understand that not everybody's gonna clap for us, not everybody's gonna smile. There are people who wish that we wouldn't survive, because us surviving means it's gonna be bad for them, because their children having food every day, having a place to stay, having a comfort zone, never reached those places. Because I'm pushed to say, it's not about the comfort zone. It's about the pain that pushes you from where you are to where you need to be. It's never about the comfort zone.
Never.
Because there are people who get a lot of comfort. They get a lot of money from home, but they never reach their dreams. Or they are never what their parents want them to be. Exactly. So we're at this point in time where life taught us that not everybody that smiles at you wants you to succeed. There are people who will smile now and talk behind your back and delegitimize what you are trying to do. I don't know.
Hey, this song is our favorite.
Yeah.
I think that's like we have a problem with our radio since we've come from Somerset East. It's giving us problems there and there. You know, I think I can have three Tata Max. I think in any way it does. Yeah, because you know, we're shukuma.
Yeah, you know, Max, as I was continuing with this thing, we have been with you, Brass, since 2006. When you count from 2006 to 2016, it has been 9 years, eh? It's 9 years.
Yeah, it's nine years.
Umama was also like 2008.
It was 2008.
It was a difficult time for us that time, Max. Reason being that Umama was coming from humble beginnings. And she came to Somerset East because she had a higher post that she was accepted to pursue, and Weza, and in fact when we talk extreme, she was the one that brought us here. We didn't want to come to a place that we didn't know, because we're so used to Grahamstown so much, and we had friends there, we had people that we looked up to there. But because she had to move, we had to follow. But it was a blessing in disguise, I want to say that, because I believe that when God plans your life, he first finishes it and then comes to start it. Because my mother came and tore 80, she left us, and I wondered to myself, why would we come here and the person that brought us here would leave us here? And it started to unfold as years went by. We started breaking boundaries and accomplishing things that people never thought would accomplish. So I think that it was a blessing in disguise, to a point that God allowed us, because God knew that in our own capacity would never come to Somerset East, because there's nothing bringing us here. So he had to use somebody who he knew that when she moves, we had to move with her. So Max Brazi, Brazman, yeah. Even their brothers in the choir on the for the likes of 2 point, no Shane. Abanga choir 2 point. I was a little ubuyile esikolweni. Ushane naye phangela usemosilbay. We have reached and e boundaries, Braz. We have cried together. We have Benz, I don't know what. We have cried together. We have laughed together for 9 years. And If a friendship relationship lasts for more than 4 years, then it lasts for a lifetime, I believe so. And you have been living with us under the same roof since 2007 now. Until now, we have been sleeping in the same beds, eating the same food. Sometimes there was no food to eat. But you would go and take their own plate of food and enjoy them with us. So I believe that is true friendship, and nobody would do that. So you made us in Dobangabana, the pain of losing our mother, you absorbed that pressure. It was a difficult time. Our mother never saw us succeed in anything. In fact, she would say, I pray that God will bless you and you'll be top in everything you do. But she was never here to witness what she was praying for. But I believe that when you pray for something, prayer is deep, because prayer never expires. Lanba, you can die, but your prayer will still live on and protect your children and protect your generation. And God would respect you to a point that and noba sewumkile Max kube khona izinto eziphuma nomthandazo wakho. So let us freshen up and continue with our journey.
Yeah, so to the pants.
Yeah, I must put in pants.
We've traveled a great distance since Somerset East. And if you've noticed, when we passed through Craydock, a lot of emotions went through me, because the struggle became personal to us, in the sense that our parents are the product of the struggle. They were also oppressed by the past regime. So when you passed through Craydock and I saw the signs there written at the cradle of four graves, I remember four young men, the likes of Matthew Koniwe, Fort Kalanta, Sparrow Mkondo, and Stelo Mhlawuli, who fought for the struggle brutally. Their car was intercepted near PE, and their bodies were badly burnt. You know, when we pass through the borders and when you change provinces, one needs to understand that we have traveled so far, spiritually, socially, in a sense that we can now associate ourselves, we can now stop, we can now talk in any language that we please, because those kind of people laid down their lives to ensure that we have such an education. It's an education that we wish that all South African children, black, white, Indian, African children, should benefit from. It is however not a secret that ever since the government freed us, there are some things that are not really inclined to the policies of what they promised us, but we are still in a Nelson Mandela said, a luta continua. So we believe that the struggle still continues. If it was not Mandela who said the struggle continues, that means a lot needs to be done. And I believe that it is now time to invest in the youth. It is so much time to invest in the youth of South Africa so that the government ensures that the product of the youth of today is going to liberate more of the country. So we are here now in Bloemfontein and we feel honored that I think it's the last trip that we are going to have with you since we are going abroad. And may God richly bless this soul in every way.
Sir Cosman, as their friend, what do you have to say about the things?
I just want to say that it's with more difficulties and stuff you see in our lives. We're sharing such things that were coming unto us while we were growing up, and family matters and all that stuff. I wish them more and more success actually to come. You see, even though they are going to Wuhan, China, and so on, you see, I'm feeling like happy. I'm happy but sad in such a way, because when a loved one is going away for such a period of time, or for five years. So it's painful. Because we have that thing of saying, who will you cry to when you have a problem? Actually, we used to share some certain things in our lives and stuff, and we used to advise ourselves in such a way. Even you know that I'm talking about.
Yeah,
I don't have what to say actually. I just wish them a great life and a great success, and I just thank God actually for what is going on to their lives. I thank you.
Kuke ngamadolo akhonze lezi zithixo ngizomthatha ngimfake emlilweni. The Bible says, but these men made up their minds, we will serve no God.
Yes,
Lord. And the Bible says, Nebuchadnezzar was so furious, he said, bring this man, bring this man. They brought this man, they brought them closer. He said to them, you do not bow to my gods. They said, oh King Nebuchadnezzar, there's no way we will bow down to your gods. They made up their minds, there's no way we will bow our knees.
still not there. Was able to move.
Yeah, but I'm just a move. Yeah, no, it's a bit late. But I'm asking a yens. Ingati ni to food no kabelis.
Ah, kalo unga kumba mama. Di kalo ba kumba mama funu kabela la.
Eh.
Ba kumba mama
funu kabela. Funu kabela. Yo, ngapu. I'm not
coming.
Who's back?
Who's back?
That's up, please.
So, I'm a lap.
No, it's my response.
Hello.
Max Bug Station. This is where everybody meet, coming and going. Local, the Eastern Cape. Sometimes,
my best work ever my Cape Town. It passes long as bunch of up. Yeah, but so wish I pass all in the upper. This is only a station for the trains and buses. If light is overcome. So this is where everything happens. This is where everything happens.